Good morning and welcome to Ridgewood Park United Methodist Church. Streaming to you from the heart of Dallas, Texas, we are so excited to share these holy and sacred moments of worship as we lift up our voices in praise of God. And my friends, we have a special treat for you. Today in our denomination, we celebrate Children's Sabbath. Our children are going to be leading the way all through our worship service today. So as the excitement builds, my friends, let us prepare our hearts and our minds to celebrate, to praise God, and to worship together.
Good morning. Welcome to Ridgewood Park United Methodist Church. Today we are celebrating Children's Sabbath, a day we recognize the gifts of children and youth and celebrate that God calls all of us His children. Now for some announcements. Your opinion matters to us. We sent out a survey earlier this week asking you for your thoughts on online worship. We hope that you and your family will take time to complete that for us. Now get excited. We are planning to hold in-person worship on Sunday, November 1st at 10:30 a.m. in our sanctuary. Please watch for our Facebook page and website for details on safe reopening plans that our trustees are putting into place. Now let us continue our worship as we sing our opening song, This Little Light of Mine, led by Hope Roberts.
Join us in our call to worship. When the disciples tried to keep children from Jesus,
Jesus said, "Let the children come to me."
When the disciples wanted to send hungry people away, saying there were too many to feed,
Jesus said, "We can feed them."
When a parent whose child was in terrible trouble came to Jesus,
Jesus said he would help.
When a woman in poverty gave what she could,
Jesus honored her generosity.
We gather in the name of that Jesus who welcomed the children, fed hungry people, helped children in trouble, and recognized the gifts of those in poverty. On this Children's Sabbath day, let us follow him in word and in deed.
Amen. Amen.
Please join me in our affirmation of faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day, he arose from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Dear God, today we come to you as children of faith. Each of us, no matter how old we are, is a child of God. When we trip, you pick us up, dust us off, and place us back on the path. When we run in directions that are harmful, you are ready to rescue us. When we shout our disbelief, you offer to us your love and are ready to receive us. Today, as we have gathered, remembering all those who have gone before us, who have paved the way for our faith, help us to be aware that we stand in the same long line of witnesses to your love. Give us courage and strength to serve you in all that we do. Remind us again that you are not looking for us to be perfect before we come to you, for you will take our rough edges and make them smooth. You will find the sparkling gem in the rough stone. You will help us learn to serve and witness your love. Let us place our trust and our lives in your loving care. For we ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, who taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Think of all working bees we love the most. There's a bee, making honey, making yummy honey for you and me. We love the honey bees buzzing all.
Good morning. It's time for children's time. Well, I usually gather all the children close, but look, they're all here with me today. We are so excited to be celebrating Children's Sabbath. Today, Pastor Bill told me that we were going to be talking about Pass It On. And so then I went, boop, I knew exactly what we were going to talk about. And since it's so close to Halloween, right?
Yes.
I got out my bumblebee costume because the bees are so great at passing it on, right? You know what they do. They move that pollen from flower to flower to create more fruits. And so I asked all of our children today to come and share some of our bee statements. Those are the fruits of the Spirit. Here they go.
Be love.
Be good.
Be faithful.
Be kind.
Be patient and be peace.
Be joy.
Be gentle.
Hive self-control.
Oh, hive self-control. You get it, right? Be hive, right? Everybody got that? Well, we are so excited that we want you guys to be taking these words and thinking about these things as you go about your daily days. Your daily days. But yes, we want you to be able to talk to your neighbors, talk to your family, talk to your friends, and pass on these wonderful fruits of the Spirit. Think about them as you go about your week this week. Be kind, be good, be patient. And most of all, hive some self-control. What do we say to that, guys? Have a great week. We'll see you next time.
You can hear them coming with their buzzing sound.
My friends, let me ask you a question. What would you like to pass on? What would you like to be remembered for? What would you like to share with the world that will live on? What would you like to pass on? You know, that's an interesting question that oftentimes we don't think about until the twilight years of our life or until there's an emergency that happens in our lives. And then we begin to think, what will we pass on? What will we be remembered for? You know, I want to share with you, I oftentimes find comfort in the Psalms, these ancient hymns that are sung. And I pray those hymns daily. But I also find comfort in our hymnal, in the wonderful hymns that are there that teach such rich theology. I pray those hymns. I wish I had a voice. I wish I had a voice like Jude and Laura did just a moment ago. I wish I had that type of voice, but I know I don't. But I pray those hymns in my life. And one of my favorites has got to be that hymn that Laura and Jude sang, The Lord of the Dance. And let me just say that this was almost not a hymn. Did you know that Lord of the Dance was written by a person by the name of Sidney Carter in 1963. It actually was born in the midst of protests happening all across America. It was written in the spirit of Bob Dylan, of Pete Seeger, of Peter, Paul, and Mary. It became an anthem in youth choirs all across the country. Would you believe that churches actually protested Lord of the Dance? In 1988, at a session of General Conference, you know, that's the global decision-making body of the United Methodist Church that happens every 4 years. At General Conference, as delegates from all over the world came, there was a hymnal revision committee that was tasked with creating, revising a new hymnal for us. And in that hymnal, we found wonderful hymns of Charles Wesley and others. But you would not find Lord of the Dance. You wouldn't find it. And it was opening session. It was the first sermon in front of the world at General Conference in 1988 that United Methodist Church Bishop Woody White began his sermon quoting the lines of that hymn, Lord of the Dance. And as he began to quote those lines, he built his entire sermon around Lord of the Dance. And he went through that hymn and he told how important it was in his faith formation growing up, how much he learned of the victory over death, of Jesus and the resurrection and the promise of resurrection in our lives. And it was after that sermon that people were so moved. People began to look up this hymn, Lord of the Dance. They began to read the lyrics. And a delegate made a motion that that be included in the hymnal. And overwhelmingly, it found its place in our hymnal. Usually we sing that song around Easter time because it has a wonderful Easter time message. But I think it's important for us to hear today, because when we talk about passing something on, when we talk about passing something that we will be remembered by, imagine a songwriter, Sidney Carter, penning a hymn that became a popular song with Pete Seeger. Imagine, we are still talking about Bishop Woody White and the story behind that hymn that found its way in our hymnal. What will you pass on? You know, I'm reminded of that second verse of Lord of the Dance. It said, I danced for the scribe and the Pharisee, but they would not dance and they would not follow me. Now let's just take a moment and let's look at this dance, if you will, between Jesus and the scribes and the Pharisees. Over the last several weeks, we've been looking at several questions that this group, this religious governing group, were asking of Jesus. And in this dance, we find several partners. On the one hand, we find Jesus, but on the other hand, we find Pharisees. And in our scripture today, we find Herodians. Now, Pharisees were religiously devout persons. Herodians, though, were followers of Herod Antipas, who was the Jewish king. And they believed that he was the divine king. So let us join this dance as it unfolds. In Matthew chapter 22, beginning in verse 15, it says, Then the Pharisees met together to find a way to trap Jesus in his words. They sent their disciples, along with the supporters of Herod, or Herodians, to him. "Teacher," they said, "we know that you are genuine and that you teach God's way as it really is. We know that you are not swayed by people's opinions because you don't show favoritism. So tell us what you think. Does the law allow people to pay taxes to Caesar or not?" Knowing their evil motives, Jesus replied, "Why do you test me, you hypocrites? Show me the coin used to pay the tax." And they brought him a denarius. "Whose image and inscription is this?" he asked. "Caesar's," they replied. Then he said, "Give to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and to God what belongs to God." When they heard this, they were astonished, and they departed. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Pastor, are we going to talk about paying taxes on Children's Sabbath Sunday? Is that really what we're going to get at, is paying taxes? Really, the scripture has very little to do with taxes. Let's explore it a little bit. I mean, Jesus is probably standing out in front of the temple. And these two enemies, the Pharisees and the Herodians, that could never agree and couldn't get along, managed to combine forces to trap Jesus in a trick question. And you see, the question was, because everyone who lined up at the temple to worship, would you believe they had to pay a tax? Every one of them had to pay a tax, and it was a certain tax. It was a certain coin that had the emperor's picture on it, engraved in that coin. So they trapped Jesus with this question. "Jesus, is it lawful?" No, remembering these Old Testament laws, is it lawful for us to pay that tax? You see, if Jesus says, "No, it is not lawful, you shouldn't pay that tax," then now he's a traitor. He is a rebellious sort trying to create an insurrection to the Roman Empire. Oh, we've got him. But if Jesus says, "Yes, it's lawful to pay that tax," he's endorsing an image of an emperor that claims to be divine in the collection box for the temple. I mean, it was an impossible question. And Jesus says, "Let me see that coin." And he looks at the coin and he studies the coin. Well, that's Caesar's image. You give to Caesar what is Caesar's and give to God what is God's. Now, what's fascinating here is this really isn't a scripture about paying taxes or not paying taxes. It's about image. It's about image. You see, Jesus asked for this coin, and they perhaps presented a coin similar to this. This coin is 1,700 years old. This coin is a Roman coin from Emperor Constantine's reign in the mid-300s. It was minted in Herculaneum. And if you could see that on our camera, it clearly has the picture of the Roman emperor in the coin. And Jesus looked at this image and said, "Whose picture is this image? Who is this?" And they said, "Caesar's." "Well, this belongs to Caesar." But when Jesus says, "Give what belongs to God to God," where is that image of God in us? Where is that image of God imprinted on us like it is this coin? I love Children's Sabbath because it reminds me of the honesty, the passion, the excitement of our children. And if you could have been in the sanctuary with us this evening as we were creating this worship experience, my friends, it was full of the excitement of children. when I look at them, when I see them praying, when I see them leading worship, when I see them singing, my friends, my heart is filled with joy because what I see is the image of God printed on their hearts. And it's a reminder for me, as I get caught up in the chaos of life at times, it's a reminder for me, and maybe a reminder for you, that if we can see the image on these children's hearts, shouldn't they see the image of God on ours? I'm not always good with living into that image. And you probably share that with me. As we go through this next week, maybe we need to reflect on that hymn, "The Lord of the Dance." Maybe we need to reflect on what we leave behind, what we pass on, what our children will take into their hearts and remember those words of wisdom. But the way also that we loved our God and the way that we served our God. And I hope and I pray that our children and our grandchildren remember the image of God printed on our hearts. I hope that is what we pass on. In that last verse of Lord of the Dance, we find such hope. It says, "They cut me down and I leapt up high. I am the life that'll never, never die. I live in you, and you live in me. I am the Lord of the dance," said he. My friends, let us give to God what is God. And my friends, let us learn to dance like no one is watching. And may our children and our grandchildren and those who remember us remember the image of God printed on our hearts. Let us pass that on. And the people of God said, amen.
Dear church, Thank you for giving. Everything you give helps support our church and all of God's people.
Let us pray.
God of grace, it is our delight and our devotion to give these gifts to you. All we are and all we have are yours alone. Accept this joyful offering as a token of our love. Use it to bring peace and comfort to all the world. Amen.
Please join us in the closing hymn. I'm going to sing when the Spirit says sing.
So my friends, it has been a blessing worshiping with you, and I hope you have been blessed by this time of worship together. Let it feed us. Let it nourish us. Let it give us fuel to go out and to live our lives with the imprint of God on our hearts. And let all of those who look at us see the image of God within us. So go now to serve the living God whose image we bear. We go knowing that God goes with us. May all our work be done in faith. May all our efforts be filled with love. Go and persevere with the hope that comes through Jesus our Christ. And the people of God said, Amen.
Lost my partner, what'll I do? Lost my partner, what'll I do? Lost my partner, what'll I do?
Everybody!
Another one prettier than you. I'll get another one prettier than you. I'll get another one prettier than you.
Everybody!
Flies in the buttermilk, shoo shoo shoo. Flies in the buttermilk, shoo shoo shoo. Flies in the buttermilk, shoo shoo shoo. Skip to my darling. Lots more verses, but this'll have to do. Lots more verses, but this'll have to do. Lots more verses, but this'll have to do. Skip to my
one more time. Hey, 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 hey. It is a blessing to share these wonderful, holy, and sacred moments of worship with you. Welcome to First United. That's not us.